Hello everyone, and finally it is here. As soon as this demo was out in Europe, I was all over it, downloading it and installing it onto my console. And now it's installed, it's time to get started. I've actually already played around with it a little bit so that I could get a basic idea of how the game works and all that stuff, so that I could tell you guys about the game. And let me just tell you, it's awesome, and so far I'm loving it. I really, really am. So, what did they give us in this particular demo? Okay, so in this demo, they give us a couple of things. So, they give us options. Options is pretty standard, probably the same thing that you're going to see in the game. You're going to see the audio, the voice, brightness, blah, 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 gameplay options, minimap rotation, connectivity. Whatever, status display, basic stuff in your options. They give you a countryside quest, which is a good thing, because if you create a character in character edit on the countryside quest, you're going to be able to see the character that you created, which is awesome. And you guys are going to get to see the character that I'm going to be playing in the final version of the game. And I'm not sure if you guys are going to like it or not, but me personally, I love it. I think it's awesome. So there's the prologue quest, which they give you a little bit of quest, a little bit of storyline. Then the countryside quest, which is pretty much a quest where you're going to find fight a griffin. And they give you the character editor. And the character editor is so amazing. You guys have no idea. It is a very in-depth character creator. Like, as you can see here, this is my the character that I've created. Mock him all you want, he's a dwarf. You guys already know that I only play dwarfs, and I'm actually really glad with the fact that they allowed me to create a dwarf. And now let me just give you an idea of the kind of stuff that you can do in this game. So you can, like, for instance, let's check out faces. You have the preset faces, you can select whatever face you want, change your character however you want. These are a whole bunch of preset faces that you can then change to do whatever you want with them. So, like, this is the face I selected. Now let's say, okay, let's try out a different hairstyle. You can try out all the hairstyles, and apparently the female hairstyles too, because I'm not sure how male this hairstyle looks to me. Or, well, this one, I guess it's acceptable, but I don't know, everything looks kind of female in my character, because he's a dwarf obviously, so this is the only one that really fits. There's face shape, which changes the shape of your character's face and whatnot. And there's a whole bunch of other stuff, mouth, nose, ears. You can then edit the body, the stature. There's a lot of, I mean, it goes all the way down to what type of legs do you want? Do you want these ones? Do you want some larger ones? Some more up ones? It has so much stuff. And I also really like the music in this character creator, because it's not like, oh, I'm so bored of this music while you're creating your characters. The music is actually really cool. I mean, just notice the music in the background. You know, it's a cool music. It's got beat, it's got movement, it's a cool music, and you have all this other stuff you can do. I mean, just look at the details, just on scarring. There's like 48 types of scarring you can put on your character. It's ridiculous. Did I actually just change my character? Whatever. Anyways, I want to discard all edits, yes, to pawn customization. And my pawn is also going to be a dwarf, because it's going to be like Rurikon and Rurikane. It's going to be two dwarfs. This is going to be my pawn. This is going to be the character that you guys are going to be able to summon. If you're playing Dragon's Dogma on the PSN, you guys are going to be able to summon him. I'm still not sure what I'm going to make my pawn. At this point, I'm considering more of a support type class to support whatever I happen to be doing. So probably some kind of a mage or whatever, but he's still going to be a fat dwarf. It's going to be awesome. So yeah, just discard all edits, whatever. I don't want to change anything. They were perfect the way they were. I just wanted to give you guys some insight of what you can do with the character editor. Also, if you create your main characters in the demo, you're going to be able to import that when you get the game. So you can get started now, spend all the time you want doing it, creating your character, so that when you receive the game, all you got to do is play. You don't have to spend all that time that we usually spend creating characters, because everything's done. But now that we've been through most of the superficial features of what you can do in the demo, let's get started on something a little bit more interesting, shall we? Prologue quest.
Yeah. choice falls not to me, nor to the whims of fate. It is yours alone.
In another place, in another life, another child of man blazes your path.
How dark it's gotten. Have you a light source? So, supposedly, in this particular part of the demo, I assume that this guy over here, Salde, is supposed to be like your main pawn. So this would be if you would use the most default options. This is what your character would look like when you're playing the game and all that stuff. So now let's talk a little bit about what we see here. So we got the minimap on the lower left. We got something on the lower right that tells you just about everything you need to know. Like L2 will sheathe your sword, or you can draw it. R2 is a grabbing motion. You can actually grab this guy over here, for instance. And then you can like throw him. Or you can put him down. I'm just going to put him down. I don't want to throw the dude. Actually, I can just show you throwing him. Like, you can just... Bong. He can just throw anything. You can grab and throw just about anything in the game. So, L2 sheaths, R2 grabs. Then you have your heavy attack, basic stuff. Which is like a thrusting motion with this sword. You don't really get to play around with it too much, so... You don't get to try the weapons in this demo. You can try the bow and the knives on the next quest, but whatever. So you got your heavy attack, you got your short attack, or your light attack, whatever you want to call it. You got your jumping, and obviously the light attack is like a combo type thing. Not sure if you can chain them together. No, it doesn't look like it. So, as you can see, you got your light attacks, your heavy attacks, you got your sheath, your grab. And now here's where things get interesting. If you press L1, everything changes. So now, we have a couple of things here. Now for starters, when you press L1, your character locks in place. So if you want to spin around, so that you know where you're blocking from. So it's important to know which direction you're blocking from. So that's the first thing I got out of it, which is important because one of the things that I don't like about Kingdoms of Amalur, it's like, suppose that there's something behind me and I just press L1 and I automatically block everything from every direction. And I prefer this style over here, which is more of a Dark Souls type of style, which is you actually have to be facing whatever you're blocking. So after that, what can you do while you're pressing L1. So you can do this thing, which I think is amazing. Damn it, idiot. You just covered the animation. Stop moving. So this is like a taunt. It's like, come at me. I love this. It's like you can actually taunt. So you actually become an effective tank for your team. It's like, come at me, bro. Come at me. So it's this is obviously a taunt. And then there's this, the shield strike. Shield strike is like a stunning type of thing, or maybe something to break enemy block. At least that's what it strikes me as, the shield strike. And then, and you guys are wondering, oh, so it doesn't make any damage? No, this one does not make any damage, but there's another one which is called Symbol Attack, which I don't know why they call it Symbol Attack. To me, this is going to be called the Shield Slam, and it does shield slams. This right here is a shield slam, and it does a whole bunch of damage. Trust me, I've been playing around with it, and it does decent amount of damage for me to use it. So now, if you quickly take a look at the lower left corner, you'll see that there's a orange bar that's filling up. That's your stamina gauge. When you block, you're out of stamina. When you release, your stamina starts obviously filling up again. Same thing when you attack. When you attack, if you're actually hitting something, you will drain your stamina. At least I think you drain your stamina when you attack. Not 100% sure. I only played it twice. But something that is important for stamina is when you're grabbing on to stuff. Like, I believe if I grab this guy, my stamina will go to ballistic. See? Stamina getting dropped. And this is also when you're clutching onto monsters and whatnot, your stamina will drain as well. The green bar is obviously your health. And then, I've just been showing you the L1 attacks because it's the shield slams and whatnot. Now let's talk about R1. R1 will give you access to your other weapon, which is the sword. And it lets you do the blink strike, and the blink strike is pretty sweet. It's like a charge. So this thing has two things I love, which is a charge and a shield slam. As you can see, this is the charge right here. So besides the charge, you also have access to a skyward slash, which is meant to attack enemies from above, mostly. At least that's what I take out of it. And then you have this hindsight slash, which is pretty sweet. It's basically a jump back and then counterattack type of thing. See? And these are all the attacks they give you access to in the prologue quest of the demo. Now that we've done all this, let's access the inventory here for a little bit. And you can access both characters' inventories, and then you can have them use healing spells on themselves, I assume. So my character is called Savan, apparently, and basically what they order you to do right at the start of the demo is use your lantern. And apparently the light of the lantern depletes itself, so you'll have to buy oil and whatnot to actually proceed. But let's go on ahead a little bit, because I've just been chatting and chatting and chatting, and I just won't shut up because I love this game. Oh yeah, I forgot to tell you guys, in order to run, it's like FPS, you just press down on L3. And now we've got a dragon over here. What's up? And he's blowing up stuff and whatever. I assume that this dragon is important to the story, but since you don't have access to the story itself in the demo, you don't know a whole lot about it, which is the best way to do it. Anyways, here are some goblins, so I'm going to be slashing up these goblins. And as you can see, let's do a little hindsight. Whoops, messed up there. Why the hell is my character facing that direction? There we go. Let's get rid of these goblins here. Missed a couple of attacks there. I'm still not very used to the fact that you can't lock onto your targets, and I love locking onto targets, but not in this game. So now we jump down, and they give you access to this little stone here, and this stone is supposedly what you will use to summon pawns in the game. Now, remember, this is the first time I'm having access to the demo, so I'm pretty sure that other commentators have spoken everything there is to know about this game, but not me. So this stone right here supposedly will take you to a location where you will be able to see other people's pawns, and you'll be able to summon pawns. But in the demo, you just click examine, and it's going to summon a couple of pawns for you. Go and touch that stone. In this case, it looks like it summons some kind of a ranger and a mage. And damn, that mage is ugly. She looks like ass. I'm sorry. And as you guys can see, there's like a couple of boxes in here and whatnot, and you can pretty much grab all the boxes and throw them around and whatnot. So everything in the game that looks like you can grab it, you can probably grab it and throw it around. Like I said, I can even grab Morgana over here. Hey, Morgana, get over here. What? Get over here. Sucks to be you. Yeah, a lot of fun. And you can pretty much chat with your NPCs and whatnot by pressing the circle. Here's another pop, you can go, you can give them orders as well and whatnot. The one thing that I still haven't mastered is what's happening in the game at all times. Like, it is a little bit confusing sometimes because you do have four people on screen, and it's kind of annoying to try and figure out what everyone is doing. Anyways, let's just stun this guy right here. Let's give him a couple of shield slams like a boss. What's up? Get shield slammed, son! He grabbed him, and then I just shield slammed the crap out of him. Oh, there's another goblin in there. Where are you going, goblin? Get rocked! As you can see there, doing the blink strike. And we pretty much owned these goblins. And now we're going to press L3. Also notice that when you're running, it also gets rid of your stamina. Your stamina gets drained when you're running, so be careful about that. You'll always want to enter a battle with full stamina. It's very important. As you can see, this is going to be the main boss that we're going to be fighting in this particular demo right here. There is, however, a side room in here that there's a guy getting attacked by goblins. And you can get in here and save his ass. You can also throw goblins around, like, oh, I got a goblin. Bong. You can throw everything around. And as you can see, we just saved this guy right here. Now we can talk to him. You've come. I fear our defeat is plain to see. So it looks like these guys were defeated. We fought to inundate the worm with sheer numbers, a sea of blades. 'Twas a fool's. Poor you. Our sea runs dry, and the Duke's army is lost in the gambit. Arisen, I beg you, sir. Blah, 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 blah. Anyways, he gives you a potion. So now let's move onward. More bodies. And now we get these RP type things. I don't really like these things. They're annoying as all hell. I'm gonna try and taunt it. Come at me. No, you won't draw its attention because I've already sliced it down. The one thing that I don't like is the fact that you can't take a support roll, like, at least not in the demo yet. You can't really take a support roll and, whoa! What do I want to do? Yeah, let me just grab this thing. And the crap? No! Grab it! Yes, indeed. Whee! Bong! Now let's throw another one. Whee! It looks like I fell on my ass. That was a little bit too high of a ledge to fall down from. That guy is dead. What else do we have? The sound in the game is really, really good as well. The sounds are looking pretty solid. This is only the demo. Apparently, according to what they've said, this is like a pre-beta version or a pre-beta version of the game or whatever. Okay, here it comes. It hates fire, so you're gonna set it on fire? Oh, it looks like you kind of missed there. Come at me. You get shield slam to the face. Blink strike. So you're gonna have to master all of these different attacks in order to be a really good player of this game, pretty much. So as you can see, they're going for the blink attacks, and it gets a little bit chaotic, I'll give you that much. Whoa, come at me. Come at me, Stone RP. Oh, looks like you fell down there. Blink strike. Come at me. Oh, looks like you fell down again. The hell's going on? Oh yeah, the cavalry's arrived, late as usual. We've pretty much mastered everything, don't worry about your failure. Okay, looks like we still have one. As you guys can see, my blades are currently enchanted by fire. Actually, both my weapon and my shield are enchanted by fire, which is a good thing because you guys know I'm all about those shield slams. And that is the mage that does that. She enchants stuff with fire. So that's what I'm talking about when I talk about a support role. She enchants stuff with fire. She heals. Like, for instance, right now, you see that green stuff on me? That's going to explode soon and heal everyone, see? So that's the type of pawn that I want to make. I want to make a healer pawn to support my main character, which is going to be a tank. And then the other two can be whatever the hell they want. And now I guess it's time to fight the main dude.
Beyond that grand door, the dragon makes its roost.
Okay. So what now? What now, good sir? Whee!
I feel it close by, Arisen. Stay ever ready as we advance.
I will. Oh, so we're supposed to go up to this door. There we go. And here it is. The tiger, goat, snake thing. Nom 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 nom. Look at him as he feasts on the corpse of that dude. Nom 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 nom. And he's gone. Anyways, let's go ahead and get started on this boss right here. So you can... He's like three bosses in one. Oh, I'm already knocked down by the poison and whatnot. Jesus Christ. Anyways. She's trying to stop the caster part of the dude. I don't have a lot of time to explain you guys what's going on, but basically I'm going to jump on top of it and grab with R2. There we go. God damn it. Oh, I'm sleeping. Great. This is perfect. Is it going to eat me now? You son of a bitch. Oh yeah, it's owning my face. Thanks. Thanks a lot, bro. Okay, now let's get on top of it. There we go. And now I want to cut your friggin' head off. You can pretty much take out the goat, which is the spellcaster, if you just hang on top of here. Now the problem is, obviously, if the tiger starts moving or whatnot, it's going to be a pain in the ass. Yeah, see? It is going to start wearing down our stamina a lot more. But I'm going to keep wailing on the goat here. Damn, my health is going low as hell. Oh, there we go. Nice heal cast there. Still grabbing onto this goat. And there we go. I took out the goat, pretty much. And it looks like he kicked me out of top of him. I'm going to grab a hold again, because I want to go ahead and take out the snake now. As you can see, I'm trying to move as the thing is... I mean, it's just so amazing that I'm, like, grabbing onto him as he's moving throughout the room. Now, obviously, I did fall down at this point, because you can't just grab a hold forever. I'm going to try and stun it a little bit. Come at me. Come at me. Just the roar takes me to the floor. Try to stun it. There we go. Okay, now let's grab a hold of it once again. Let's try to go for that snake. I want to grab the snake. There we go. I'm almost there. Come on. Almost at the snake. Damn it. I just can't grab a hold long enough. And now, as you can see, my stamina is down, which means I can't really do anything. I'm gonna have to try and get behind it. Oh, damn. Almost dead. So now it's time to go into this thing. I suppose that they will come up with something more practical on the final version of the game, hopefully, so that you can heal yourself in a better way. Yeah, I can tell that the snake splits funny. Come on, I really need to move. Ah, there we go. Chopped off the snake, and now he's going to be a lot harmless. Oh, you're on the floor now, are you, bitch? Well, I think it's time for a nice little shield slam to the face! Shield slam, son! Shield slam, that's right. Shield slam in that face of yours, that ugly mug! Think I give a damn? Bring it on, son. I'm going to grab onto your head, smack it open. Oh, he actually threw me on the floor, you bastard. Okay, well, here we go. A little blink attack action. Jump on top of it. Slice it open. Now, obviously, I don't have a lot of stamina, so as soon as he starts wiggling around, down I go once again. If you guys look at his face, it's like his eyes are on fire because of what the spellcaster was making. So that was a good job by the spellcaster. I really should heal. It would be a lot safer if I did. I don't think I'm actually damaging it a whole lot. I need to attack it at the face. Good. She just threw a heal on me. And it AoE'd onto everyone else. Perfect. Now let's climb on top of this sucker right here. I'm trying to climb up to his head. No good, no good. Stamina. You see how balanced it is? Because if you can't just climb on top of something and wail away forever, because your stamina will get expended. Let's get on it. Let's finish this! Damn it, bastard. Come at me. I can't even see what the hell's going on. I'm gonna do a shield slam. Gotta finish it with a shield slam. Come on. Get up, get up! Shield slam time! Can't see a damn thing. Oh, it's dying. Good. Dead already. That's right. That's right. You're dead. Look at you now. Look at you now on the floor there. Come on. Tell me this is not amazing. Choose, flee, or step forth. Take hold of what lies beyond. Claim mastery over the eternal ring. Of course, they're not going to show us anything else. They're just going to say, Arise 5 2012. See what I mean? So that is the prologue quest that they give you access to in the demo. It is amazing. It really shows off a lot of the game's capabilities. It also shows one of its main downsides so far, which I see it is the frame rate, because it has a lot of visual detail, a lot of awesome action, great animation. The animations are just amazing, especially for all the kind of stuff that's happening on screen. I mean, just look at that. There was a point, I believe, in that fight where we had like two or three people grabbing onto the thing and just stabbing it, and the game handles it in a way that it looks more natural than most games would, and that is an amazing thing. Now, are you guys ready to watch Rurik Khan, the character, the Dragon's Dogma character that you guys will see on the Let's Play that I'm going to be making for this game when the game comes out? Are you guys ready for him? Here he comes. So as you can see here, we are on a more open space type of field, because the game is supposed to be open world, so I think that you can just do these types of hunts whenever you want. Oh, goblins! And here he is. Rurik Khan and Rurikane. Can I get a little bit of light on my character? Thank you very much. As you can see, a dwarf. Unfortunately, for this particular mission, I'm going to be an archer. Still, it looks amazing. Just look at this. I'm going to be able to play a game where I can not only play a dwarf, I can play two dwarves. I can have my dwarf and I can have my ally be a dwarf. So that to me is just a win-win situation in my book. I'm loading different arrows right now. I'm doing the triad shot. And there is the griffin. Let's get on top of it, shall we? Woo! What's up, griffin baby? How are those wings doing, bitch? I heard you like to fly. You ain't going to be flying anywhere. I'm gonna chop off them wings. Oh, what's up? What's up, son? Looks like I'm out of stamina. I'm gonna fall down there. Basically, what I did was I grabbed onto the griffin's wings and I just slashed away. Okay, so this guy is going to send me towards the griffin. Oh, or he was. I was not fast enough. There we go. Come on, come on, come on. Whoa! Oh, we missed it. You guys saw that? But basically, your character will send you, your pawn will send you towards your target when it's an airborne target. Anyways, now that we're an archer, let's just try to aim for the fucker. Where the hell is he? Are there still goblins in here? No, there's no more goblins left. Well, looks like there's a healing section over here. There he is. Hello, griffin. Let's grab him. Ah, damn it. Okay. I'm switching to the triad shot. Hopefully I'm hitting it. Yeah, I think I'm hitting it. And here he comes. He's coming for me. Dodged ya? I can't grab. Oh-ho! There we go. Now let's grab on. Let's jump on top of his wings. Let's chop that up. Not a whole lot of stamina. He needs to stop moving. You ain't going anywhere, son. I'm going to break your goddamn wings off. There we go. Oh, what's the matter? Your wings are on fire? That's once again the enchantment from the wizard that's basically giving me fire damage on my weapons. And that is how I'm able to set his wings on fire. Oh, crap. I am aiming for the wings. I don't have enough stamina. Oh, looks like there's someone on top of it as well. Let's do that. Alright, come on, my dude is gonna send. Give me a boost. Give me a boost. Oh, sweet. Oh, damn it. I jumped off. And that was not enough. Anyways, let's go ahead and just put the heavy arrows. Heavy arrow is charging, full bend. Come on, come on. Here he comes. And I missed it. I'm not good at archers. What the hell's he doing? There you go, have another one. Oh, come on. Oh, crap, I thought he was gonna like. Not enough. Good. I'm coming at you. Launch me. Damn it, still not enough. I'm a dwarf, I can't leap that high. Let's try to shoot it off with the triad shot. Well, how's Rurikane doing? Is he still alive? Yeah. My dwarven companion is still in there. He's still in the game. Okay, is it gonna land? Okay, I'm gonna climb on top of him once again. Damn it. Failed. Oh, one of my dudes is down. I gotta go resurrect her. Ah! What the hell is going on? Good, 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 good. I'm coming right at you. Oh, sweet, I grabbed it. Crap, I'm just, your problem is that I'm grabbing it by the foot. Come on, I need to climb a little bit higher. Okay, I think I'm at the wings now. Damn it, I could only swing twice. I didn't have enough stamina there. First time I fought it, I just took it out immediately. Damn it. Ouch! He's like, can you see me now? Well, yes, I can. I grab a hold of him. There we go. Chopping your ass off. Arrgh, I don't have enough stamina. Whew, thank God for that heal. I almost died there. Okay, I've got the wings now. No, you ain't going anywhere. Son of a bitch, you ran away again. I don't have enough stamina for that. Oh, what the hell, let's try it again. Almost there, send me. Sweet, I grabbed the foot again. Stick out those wings. Get down! You're coming down. We're both going down. There we go! God damn it, I thought I had him.
Hold on.
Come on, come on. Oh, nice shot in the wings there. I got a nice shot at the wings. Come on. No! You can't fly, you bastard! Like clinging onto its tail, stabbing it in the ass. Get down here! You will come down. Come on, give me my bow. Jesus Christ, he's almost dying and he's still alive. Okay, looks like there's a heal incoming for me. Okay, and I resurrect Sid there. Come on, just launch me upwards one more time and we got this. Oh, I'm coming at you. Oh, where you? Oh, God damn it! I got thrown off. Where the hell is he? I can't even see him, it's so dark. Do I have a lantern? Yes, we do. Oh, great. As soon as I use the lantern, I almost die. Good job. Come on, come on, come on. No good. Okay, that's it. I'm ending this. Or maybe someone else will. Looks like one of my NPCs actually killed it, but it still felt pretty good. So, Rurikon here reporting in and saying Dragon's Dogma is amazing and you can expect more adventures from Rurikon and Rurikane in Dragon's Dogma. See you guys in the next one.